Yeah, what, 5 months post-op? Both 5 months post-op, BBL. So, doing pretty good with that. So far, so good. I just hope this doesn't fall. Okay. So, yeah, I just wanted to touch bases with you guys, because I haven't made a video in a few days or whatever, but I've been really busy. I'm super excited. I'm super, 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 super duper happy. I did get approved, finally. Everything's went through. I'm going to go through with the aftercare, like I was saying. So that's good. We're going to do that. But I wanted to share something personal with you today. Can I do that? Please. Okay. So. Don't get excited because I'm not that excited yet. I have been talking to this guy for about 4 months. 3 to 4 months. And it started off, like a month online. Then we started talking, conversing over the phone. And then, of course, you know, we met in person and we've been talking. Listen, he knows everything because I told him everything. There was a time when I didn't tell anybody anything back in the day. I didn't tell them I lived stealth. And let me explain to you why before I put that message out there. Because I don't, in my opinion, I don't live stealth. I'll speak that for me. I wouldn't do that. Even if I could or whatever, I'm not going to ever live stealth ever again. I did that, oh my God, in the 90s. When my early transition. Early 90s. Yeah, let's talk about stealth. Let's talk about that first. Then we're going to talk about my guy friend tomorrow. I'm sorry, but I got to bring this up because this is a serious situation. So, living stealth. I did that for the majority of my life. So, it's really hard for me to just bust out the doors and be like, oh, yes, hey, everyone, I'm trans. If you don't know, you don't know, is how I live most of my life. And I still live like that. I'm not going to walk around with a sign on my back saying that at work or anywhere else. However, when it comes down to a intimate relationship, or if I feel like I want to be romantically involved with someone, a monogamous relationship with someone, I need to say something to them. Even if it's not monogamous, you still need to be cautious these days because, let's face it, people are crazy. So we got to make sure we look out for it ourselves. I think living stealth is good for what it serves, for the purposes that it serves, which is work. The obvious stuff, just to get you through so you can pass through or whatever in important situations until, you get there, then you don't give a shit. I don't know. For me, it was for work. It was for survival. In the 90s, yes. It was so you can get through. There was a lot of times that, where people are, I'm sorry about the noise, whatever. But there was a lot of times where I was afraid because I didn't want to be fired from my job or at the hospital, or I didn't want everyone in the neighborhood where I grew up, to know my tea. Hello, Kajin. You grew up in the neighborhood, the same neighborhood you transitioned in. Yeah, they're gonna know. So... I was able to live stealth when I finally got the hell out of Hempstead, New York, and I moved to New Jersey, and then I moved to Louisiana, and then I moved again to Texas. So all of that was great. So the majority of my life I did that. Because I was so used to doing it for survival reasons. Because like I said, back in the day, ignorant guys would throw bottles at you if they spooked your tea, if they felt like you were trans or what they called at that time drag queens. Yeah, they would throw bottles at you. They would try to fight you. They would try to hurt you in any type of way. So it was important for us to live stealth back then, because we had to fight. We had to physically fight these guys off of us, you know, just to get through, just to live our lives, just to be who we wanted to be. But also for work purposes, if you were a trans woman, if you were a transgender woman and you decided to get a job, back then, you better have all your credentials correct. You better have all your paperwork right, your ID, your license, you know, your name change has to be done. Because if it wasn't, and they were doing that late 90s, like around 99 is when I had my name changed. They started allowing us to have our legal name changes. They might have been doing it a few years before that, but I didn't do it until 99, 2000. But it was, like I said, it was for me to stay. It was for survival. It was for survival reasons. You know, you had to live stealth. You couldn't, like, just tell everybody your business at your job. You know, you had to get your F on your card and have your name changed and all that stuff so you can be able to use spaces that were designed initially for females, which is the bathrooms, locker rooms, things like that. I didn't go into locker rooms, but I did go into, well, locker rooms at work, yeah. But it was just to store stuff and get the hell out. But bathrooms is super important. If you're working all day in a hospital, eventually you're going to have to use the bathroom. So, yeah. But other than that, I don't condone living stealth in this day and age because of the backlash, because of the repercussions, because there are really crazy people, and I don't want to see any more of my sisters and brothers dying from some idiot that take a gun to their head, you know, or a knife to their heart because they feel like they've been tricked or whatever, which 9 times out of 10, that is not the case. They are not being tricked. That's an excuse for their paranoia. Their masculinity has been threatened after they've had sex with the girls, and then they decide to take their lives. But this is happening a lot, and I'm going to say this. This is definitely happening a lot within the black trans community, within trans women of color are being murdered at a high rate. And it's not because they're living stealth. That has nothing to do with that. But I'm just saying, for me, back then, you didn't want people to know, because, you know, if they did, you could possibly be offed. You know, it was dangerous. It was really, really dangerous. I had bottles thrown at me. I didn't want to tell people my tea because I was scared. I was scared. You had to live. You had to feed yourself. You had to eat. I had to go to school. I had to work. So living stealth in the early stages, back then, back in the day, was super, super important for everyone. Not just me, but for everyone. But today, we have fought. Us girls like me, the older girls, we fought that fight for y'all. You guys are coming out at 9 and 10 and 5 and 6 telling your moms now that you're either male or female now. We would not be able to do that back in the day. So we had to fight, and we had to fight, and we had to fight, you know, for everything. And all I want to say is that today, be careful, because the guys today are crazy as hell. They are murdering us at a very high rate. So, you know, watch your back. If you choose to live stealth, be very, just live your life. Just live your life happily and be careful. Always be mindful of what could happen, you know, with these idiots. I don't advise tricking anybody. Living stealth and tricking someone is completely two different things. I don't believe in tricking someone. Definitely not. Always let them know. I think you take away the person's right when you don't tell them your tea. no matter how passable you are, you take away that right from them, from knowing, because they deserve to know. They deserve to know, you know, whether it's a male or a female, they deserve to know. You know, even after my vaginoplasty, I'm going to let guys know, because remember, that vagina might be pretty and all, but I'm pretty sure it's not going to be exact to, you know, a genetic one. So that's one thing. And then the other thing, there's scars. And another thing is you can't give birth. And it's a lot of reasons why you probably should tell. And, you know, here we go back to the murder thing again. There's post-op women that I know have been murdered because they didn't say anything. They'd still be here today. I wish they had said something. So that way, before these guys, before the two of them even hooked up, it, you know, it could have been avoided, because he could have went on his way and she could have went on her way and found somebody else more deserving of her. But sometimes we're so wrapped up in the midst of it all, you know, the guy's beautiful and, you know, we're desperate for love for whatever reasons. And sometimes we don't tell right away. I think it's important to tell, be upfront. You never know. Sometimes you may be surprised. A lot of these men are very interested in trans women these days. So you'd be very surprised at how things could go. But, you know, give them a chance to make that choice is what I'm saying. So living stealth and tricking someone is two different things. Living stealth, fine. Gotta get through work. I still believe in living stealth. I don't believe in tricking someone. Those two things are different. Those two things are different. I think you should always be up front, even if you are post-op. I love you guys. Keep watching. And tomorrow I'm going to tell you about my little boo that I met, and I need some advice. I need you to tell me whether or not...